Hey guys, this is a quick breakdown of how you can use the free version of Fusion 360 to make adapters for different tools. There's many ways to do this, but we'll focus on using the sketch and loft features as they're very versatile. We'll just learn the basics here, but you can use these tools to do much more complex things. So let's get into it. So here we are in Fusion 360 with a new project loaded up. So for this example, we're going to make an adapter to go from 100 millimeter hose to 50 millimeter with a 2 millimeter shell thickness. Also, we want to make sure we have a gradual transition so anything passing through is not going to get stuck. So we're going to start in sketch mode and make the first profile we're interested in. First, we need to select the plane we would like to work in. So I'm going to start with a circle centered on the origin. After I click that, I can type in the diameter I'm looking for. Like I said, we're making a 100 millimeter adapter with a 2 millimeter thickness. So I actually want to type in 104 to end up with 100 millimeter inner diameter. Now we hit enter, just like that, we made our first sketch. Next, we want to make an offset plane. That's what we're doing here. You can right click, drag that up. We'll go 30 millimeters upwards. And now we're going to repeat the first process where we make a sketch, select the plane we want, center a circle on the origin, and type in that same 104 millimeters. Pressing enter, it'll accept all that. And then we can see what we end up with, which is two offset circles. All right, so now that we've got our two sketches, we are going to actually connect them using the loft feature. So you can find the loft up here under Create, Loft. And we're just gonna select our two surfaces. And you can see there, now we have a cylinder. So it'll automatically just connect those, we'll hit enter, and now we have a solid body. So next up, we need to make another offset plane off the top there. So I select the top cylinder, offset that plane. So we'll offset this plane 40 millimeters to give it a little bit of transition room. Go ahead and hit enter. And then we'll create a new sketch on that plane with a circle centered on the origin. Except this time, we're not gonna use the 104 millimeters. We're gonna go to our new diameter size, which is gonna be 54. So type that in, hit enter, and hit enter again. And then we've got our first sketch. So we can actually make another offset plane off this one. Let's go upwards 30 millimeters and then hit enter. Now we have this final plane. We're gonna create a sketch, put a 54 millimeter circle centered on the origin and finish all this up. So you can see we have all our sketches now that we're going to need. We're going to go back to our loft function, except this time it's going to do something a little different. So instead of just making a cylinder, when we select our two planes, it's actually going to adjust the diameter gradually along the way. So this will help us not catch any material if we have a hose that we're using for a vacuum. And then we can loft these last two surfaces and hit enter. And now we have one solid body. That's going to be the backbone of our adapter. So we can look at that here from a few different angles and see that it is all just one solid piece. So now that we have a solid body, we want to hollow that out so material can actually, you know, pass through. So to do that, we're going to use this modify shell function, and we're going to select this top face. So when we select that, we'll put in our 2 millimeters. So when we do that, we'll see that it left behind a 2 millimeter shell all throughout, except on the bottom. So it actually left the bottom as a solid object. So last, we're going to create a hole. So you remember we wanted 100 millimeters. We're going to put that right on the center of the origin. We're going to put a 100 millimeter hole and to be able to drill in that last 2 millimeters, and then we can pass through the whole entire object. So after we hit enter, you can see that now I can see straight through my object. We have a 100 millimeter diameter going down to the 50 millimeter diameter, just like we were looking for. All right, so now we've got our object. Let's just check it out. So I'm going to just go through the export function in Fusion 360. So if you're gonna be 3D printing this, you're gonna wanna export it as an STL file. And these STL files are able to be opened with software such as Cura. So just load that up, hit export, and then save that to a spot on your PC. Once you have that exported, we're gonna go ahead and open that up in Cura so we can see what it'll look like on our 3D printer. So I have a Creality Ender 3 S1. And this is the adapter that we just made. You can see it's put it on the middle of the build plate. You can see you can still see through the middle. So this you can just slice up and send it to your 3D printer, however you normally do that process. So then you can just print it out and put it on whatever you're looking for to use. So this is a different one I've used in the past, connecting my table saw to my vacuum hose. And that's really all there is to it. So I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, please drop a like. Thanks. Have a good one.